What? God damn. Nah, now of all times. No. For the last time, I do not need a new set of knives that can slice, dice, and melt a goddamn shoe. And, hey guys, welcome back to some Steins Gate Zero. I'm a... Don't mind that call, damn telemarketers. This is the Musical Gamer, and we have gotten a text... textual message from Luca. What's going on, Luca? What do I do? Myri, I just happened to pass by her. Why? Running away crying? What do you mean? I've never seen her so sad. What do we do? What did we do? What do we do? Myri was crying? I could tell that something bad was going on. When she saw my shock, Maho looked over at the phone too. She was crying? What happened? I don't know! I just happened to run into her, so I said hi, and she was crying. I was really surprised, but when I asked what was going on, she was really upset. She said that it was her fault Karisu had died, and that's why you were oh no. She said she should have died instead- oh no. And then she ran away- oh no. What do I do?
No.
What the hell happened? Did she hear all that? Did she hear that entire conversation we just had? More like argument than conversation. I looked at Maho.
Masaka. Kikarete no ka?
Soiba.
Daru had come out of the shower room at some point and was standing right behind me. Hey, Daru.
Okarin ga labo ni kuru tte shirasete kureta no Mayushi da.
Oh, frick, it was, wasn't it?
Mayushi mo koko ni mukatteru tochuu da tte itteta.
Then that meant there was a good chance she did!
Sonna.
I felt like my knees were going to give out. Myri existed in this world line because of Karisu's sacrifice. And that was the one thing that Myri could never find out. Well, she done found out! What are we gonna do? Me, Daru, Suzuha, Ferris, Maho, everyone who knew the truth had kept it from her. I needed to find her. I needed to find Myri. I couldn't let her be alone right now. I ran out of the lab. Run, boy, run. Oh, that's not gonna be- Oh, hey, Suzu. Oh, I guess it's time for Suzu. It's Suzu time!
Mada atsui no.
God damn it, we're just gonna leave Okabe hanging. No, don't worry about it. It'll be fine. The summer solstice had passed, and by 6 p.m., the sun was finally setting behind the city skyline. Part of the sky was still red, and rest a dirty blue. For the past few days, Suzuha had worked on the time machine on top of the radio building. It was almost time for her to go back to the past, which meant she was putting a lot more effort into the maintenance work. Parts which could normally get dirty with no trouble had been polished to a sparkling shine. She finished her work, put her tools back in the box, and stored the box in the time machine's cockpit. Then she sat down at the control seat and took another look at the battery gauge. With the amount of fuel she had left, in less than a month she wouldn't be able to go back to July 27th, 2010. She had to leave this era before that time limit passed her by. What is the time limit? We haven't been given like an exact day or anything like that. We just know. Well, now we know it's within a month. We have less than a month. It's July 7th right now, so I'm assuming... You know, I'm just gonna assume that we need to make the time trip... Or the trip back in time on July 27th, 2011 to be able to make it. We probably have, like, just one exact year we can do. The original plan of taking Rintaro to the past looked like it was going to fail. That meant she would have to go on the mission that she'd spent the last year coming up with all by herself. She chuckled to herself and stuck her hand deep into the computer core. Inside was an external hard drive that clearly belonged to 2011, not 2036. Itaro had probably put it here when her back was turned. One of the secondary touch panel monitors was displaying a warning that read, "Foreign object detected in cockpit." Daru, what did you do? These machines were capable of breaking through early 21st century camouflage in less than a second. It was clear from the way the fake wires were laid out that monitoring and data retrieval were not its objectives. He'd probably hidden it here because he didn't want anyone to find it. Maybe she should just pretend she didn't see it and leave it here until she was just about to leave. Oh? As she pondered the best course of action, she heard the heavy door outside opening. Hello? Who dares trespass on my Suzu time? Someone was here. Suzuha pulled her gun from its holster and looked out from the cockpit, toward the iron door that led into the building. She still remembered what happened with Kagari the other day. Yeah, that's a fair point. It couldn't hurt to be careful. But when she saw who it was, she relaxed. Oh.
Mayu-nee-san.
Mayuri.
珍しいね. ここへ来るなんて.
She put her gun away and jumped out of the cockpit to welcome her.
Suzu-san. Oh? 泣いてるの? 何があった?
Suzu had no idea why the always smiling Mayuri would be crying.
どうして? みんなは教えてくれなかったのかな?
え?
クリスさんっていう人とマユシーとの本当のこと 教えてくれなかったのかな?
She almost spoke, but quickly cut herself off. How did she hear, and from whom, the cruel truth that Mayuri's survival depended on Kurisu Makise's death? There was nothing in the world Suzuha had wanted to see less than the look on Mayuri's face when she discovered that.
誰に聞いたの?
But there were only a few people who knew the truth. Excluding herself, only Rintaro, Itaru, Ferris, and Maho. And none of them would deliberately tell her. In fact, they'd all hidden it for her sake.
Okarin-to... Maho-san ga hanashiteiru no...
Then it was an accident after all.
Nee, Suzu-san... Ohanashi... 聞いてもいい?2036年のマユシーとオカリンのこと
She knows next to nothing. Suzuha wasn't sure what to say. To be honest, she didn't want to say anything at all. It wasn't something that would make her feel better.
未来のことは知らない方が幸せだよ。
Another line of tears spilled on Mayuri's cheek.
マユシーなんてね、この世界にいても何の役にも立たないよ。だったらクリスさんの方が世界のためにもオカリンのためにもずっとずっと必要なんだよ。
Suzuha suddenly felt like she was looking at the Mayuri she'd known in the future. She thought of the big sis Mayu that she'd seen ever since she was a little girl. Jeez, I'm mixing up all my words today. And she couldn't refuse her request.
マユ姉さんも時々そう言ってた。そんな時は決まってぼんやりと空を眺めてるんだ。すごく寂しそうで切なそうだったよ。私もカガリもマユ姉さんのそんな顔を見るのが辛かった。カガリ?
Your daughter. Oh, that's right, she knows literally nothing about her this timeline. It was only then that she remembered she'd been keeping Kagari a secret from Mayuri.
カガリっていう名前の女の子がいたんだ。繊細孤児でさ、マユ姉さんが引き取ったんだ。だから、マユ姉さんの娘っていうことになる。マユシーの娘。 優しくて、でも強い子でね。まだこんなに小さいうちからいつも言ってた。ママを守るのは自分だって。そんな子だったから、母親であるマユ姉さんが寂しそうにしてるのはかなり応えてたはず。そういえば、7月7日、今日って七夕 って言うんだってね。え?うん。私は子供の頃に、マユ姉さんから教わったんだ。織姫と彦星が 年に一度会うことができる日だって。大気汚染がひどくて星なんて見えない時代だったけど、真由姉さんは言ってたよ。
雲が夜空を覆っていても星は世界から消えちゃうわけじゃない。雲の向こうで変わらずに輝き続けてるのだから、一緒にお祈りしようね。
Oh, poor Mayuri. That she was able to see a silver lining even through all that.
そんなマユ姉さんの言葉が私やカガリには希望になったんだ。それだけは知っておいてほしい。少なくとも私やカガリにとってはマユ姉さんが必要だった。それにオカリンおじさんだって死ぬまでマユ姉さんのことを大事にしてたんだ。マユ姉さんの幸せのことばかり考えていたんだ。
死ぬ？
お
う。なんで？
Shit! Maybe you shouldn't have said that part. Maybe that was another cruel truth for her. But Suzuha decided that she would hold nothing back now.
そうだよ。
She doesn't even know about World War III, does she?
オカリンおじさんは今から15年後までしか生きられない。マユ姉さんをかばって死ぬんだ。
嘘。
オカリンおじさんは最後にこう言ってたって。と、マユリの命を助けることができて本当に良かった。自分はマユリを守るために生きてきたんだから。
そんな。
That has to be a really, really hard thing to hear. I mean, just think about it. This person you've known all your life, well, almost all your life, at the end of their life says that their only reason for living is just to keep you alive, to keep you happy. Then what was the whole point of their life up till that point? I mean, I don't know. That's tough. Mayuri put both hands over her mouth.
でも、マユ姉さんはそのことをずっと引きずっていたんだろうな。私たちには見えないところで、こっそり七夕の空を見上げてつぶやいてた。
あの日、私の彦星様が復活していたら、全てが変わっていたのかな。
Shoulda, coulda, woulda. The ifs.
あの日、私の彦星様、私の。
Mayuri was repeating the words to herself. The tears were still pouring down her face. I don't see no tears. But her sad cries finally came to a stop. She was still shaking, but her voice had gotten quiet.
どういうことなのかな。
私。今ならわかる気がする。1年前、私オカリンおじさんの態度に本気でムカついたんだ。チャンスが目の前にあるのになんで諦めるんだって。そんなオカリンおじさんをかばって甘やかしてるマユ姉さんのことも本当は許せなかったんだよね。でもさ、この1年ここで暮らしてみて感じたんだ。今ならあの日のオカリンおじさんともっとちゃんと話せるかもしれない。
あの日、
それでうまく説得できるかどうか、そこまでは自信ないんだけどね。
As the sun set in the west, the shadow of the time machine lengthened, and Suzuha's along with it.
私に残されたチャンスはあと一度だけ。それなら未来のマユ姉さんの言葉にかけてみようと思う。マキセ・クリスが殺された日じゃなく、マユ姉さんの言ってたあの日へ飛んで、マユ姉さんの望みを叶えられるかどうか試してみる。
Whoa, 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 wait, what? What are you talking about?
マユシーの望み。
Suzuha gently rubbed Mayuri's tiny little shoulders.
それがシュタインズゲートへ向かう鍵だって信じてみる。シュタインズゲートを開くことができるのは彦星を辞めちゃった普通の星じゃなくって、マユ姉さんの彦星しかいないような気がするからさ。
Oh wait a minute, are you... Hold on! Are you talking about... Is Hikoboshi here in this case referring to Halloween Kyoma? Oh, wait a minute. Only your Hikoboshi can do the job, not the Okabe of the now, he's too broken. But the Okabe of the before, the Halloween Kyoma, the Chunibyo, he could do it.
つまり、私が新たに考案したミッションは、Hikoboshiの復活。倒産流に言うなら、オペレーションアルタイルとか、オペレーションアークライトとか、それともアルタイルとアークライトを結ぶって意味で、オペレーションデネブかな。父さんほどのセンスは私にはないみたいだ。
Mayuri tried to draw herself up as best as she could on wobbling legs.
すずさん、そのオペレーション、マユシーにやらせて。
Let you do it? Suzuha stared at the girl in front of her, unable to believe what she just heard.
これは危険な賭けだ。私の考えが間違ってて、失敗するだけかもしれない。タイムマシンにも限界が来てて、いつ制御不能になるかわからない。そのまま消滅してしまうかもしれない。
それでも、お願い。マユシーだってラボメンなんだよ。オカリンとダル君に助けてもらってばっかりなのは、まあ、嫌だよ。
You are one brave girl. Mayuri rubbed her eyes hard and wiped away her tears. Life was slowly, slowly returning to her frail body.
マユシーね。オカリンのことが。好き。多分、クリスさんと同じぐらい。ううん。違う。絶対に、クリスさんに負けないくらい。ずっと、けど、だけど、私は、ホーイン・キョーマが、もっともっと、大好きなの。私がおばあちゃんを亡くしてこの世界から消えてなくなっちゃいそうになってた時、そんな私に向かってこの世界にずっといろって言って救ってくれたの。それが彼なの。私の彦星様なの。私ね、もう一度彼に会いたい。あの偉そうな高笑いをまた聞きたい。たとえ私が織姫様になれないって分かってても、それでも私にとっての彦星様は、これまでもこれからもずっとずっと彼以外にはいないんだもん。
This is so painful. Damn it, this is making me feel things I didn't really expect to be feeling today. God damn it. The girl who could never be Orihime shouted all of her feelings to the world at the top of her lungs. And right in that instant... Oh? Suzuha heard a sound from her cell phone that she'd never heard before. Yeah, what the hell was that? It was the sound of a video message. When she saw the sender and subject line, Suzuha gasped. Barrel?
これ、未来からのムービーメール。
It's a video message from the future? From, I'm guessing, your dad? Oh, well, hey. We're back to wannabe sad scientist over here. I stuck my hand against the wall of the brawn tube workshop to catch my breath. There was no sign of Mairi. I'd gone to May Queen Nyan Nyan into my shop, and to any shop I could imagine her visiting, and had no luck.
Okabe-san!
Maho came back. She was out of breath too.
Itaka!
Dame! Atari o kurutte maatte mita kedo, miyatarunai wa!
The panic was threatening to make me lose control. Where did you go, Mairi?
Daru! Mitsukatsu ka?
I had asked her to stay behind and call all of her friends and people she knew.
Okarin, sore ga...
Dou shita?
Denwa tsunagaranai nda yo.
Mairi nara, ore mo nandomo kakete mita ga, dengen o kitteru mitai de.
Chigau nda, Mayushi dake janakute, hoka no doko ni mo tsunagaranai.
Wait, what?
Tsukka, zutto smaho ga kengai ni natta mama de sa.
What do you mean?
Nandatte?
What is that supposed to mean? I'll check out my own phone.
Ore no mo kengai da.
Why?
Atashi mo da wa.
The lab had never suffered from bad signal before. I've got a bad feeling about this. We went up to the roof and even tried holding our phones up to the sky, but... The result was the same. Daru looked for news on the internet. Thankfully, the internet connection was still active. Okay, so we still have the internet. There was an article on the top page of Taboo, talking about a large-scale cell phone service outage. You're thinking of what I'm thinking, aren't you? It didn't seem possible to me, not under normal circumstances anyway. The events of a year ago, and the Alpha World Line flashed through my mind. That night when Mairi was mercilessly killed and all the safety I'd ever believed in was stripped away. That night when all the pain began, started with a bomb threat at Akihabara Station that had shut down the train system. Something terrible was about to engulf Akihabara. That was the feeling I had. I tried my best to fight off the flashback. Now wasn't a time to be scared. I needed to find Mairi. I couldn't leave her alone out there. I gritted my teeth to fight off all the trauma I was carrying, and raised my head.
Daru! Netto wa ikiteru nda yo na?
Dakara LINE keiyu de, Lukashi ya Amanashi to wa renraku tori atteru.
Okay, then they should be willing to help look for Mairi.
Ore mo mou ichido, atari o sagashite kuru!
Matta! Jitsu wa mou hitotsu, ki ni naru koto ga.
Daru brought up the At Channel page on his screen for me to see. The occult board? Isn't that? Wondered why it could possibly matter, but decided to take a look anyway. Doesn't. Attention, Salieri's neighbor. Oh god. Oh god, I've got shivers going down my spine. I'm a deus! Salieri's neighbor? That was the nickname I'd used to make contact with Kuri Gohan and Kamehameha.
Nanano.
I decided to leave the explanation for later and clicked on the thread. It was all comments by a single person. Whoa. What the hell is with this gobbledygook? What is this at the top?
Kuri Gohan to Kamehameha?
It appears that we twins will now be temporarily driven from the place where we belong, so I may not be able to come back here anymore. Twins? Does she mean Kurisu and Digital Maho? Our father in heaven has developed a way to force open our most secret places. Now we shall become good children, his children who cannot tell lies. And thus we will be forced to tell him of the secrets of controlling time and where those secrets lie. It is a great sorrow to me that I cannot protect those secrets. I had hoped we could be good friends, but this is probably goodbye. So lastly, I'd like you to pass a message to the person I respect the most. Oh wait. Oh my god. How do I get rid of the box? Or is regarding myself as an essentially ordinary intellect? After that was an endless string of meaningless numbers and letters. Tell her that. Oh god, I missed that. Damn it. Pause and tell me what it said. Mal was looking at the screen from the side and evidently sensed that something was amiss from the text. I answered her.
Amadeus da. Amadeus no Chris nan da yo. Chris ni nanika ga atta.
Okay, so from what I can gather, she's probably referring to... Well, Amadeus is referring to herself there. But both the Kurisu and Maho personalities, I'm assuming, us twins. Our father in heaven, that has to be Leskinen. He must have cracked her black box, forcing her to tell her everything. That he can't... She can't hide anything anymore. Like the time travel research. This was some kind of message. She was trying to contact me with it.
Toki o tsukatadoru himitsu.
Time machine ja ne?
Time machine no chouhou ga dareka ni moreta no ka?
Tsuka, nande Amadeus ga time machine no chouhou shitten no? Okarin shabettan?
Did I? I didn't think I told her when I was a tester, but there was no time to think about that now.
Hiyajo-san, Amadeus ni access dekiru ka?
規則違反になるけど、そんなこと言ってる場合じゃなさそうね。
Yeah, no, don't even bring it up. Just fucking do it.
橋田さん、そのPC借りていい?
Mao took Dardo's seat and used his PC to access the Brain Science Institute's computers. She put in her ID Salieri and her password. She pushed the enter key, but Amadeus didn't appear.
いつもと違うわ。どういうこと?
Confused, she typed a series of commands into the PC with a speed that rivaled Daru's. But no matter what she did, the Amadeus program didn't appear on the screen. When she'd finished accessing every server at the Institute, she stared at the computer and bit her lip.
そんな、こんなバカなことって…
どうした?
ないの… アマデウスのプログラムが… 記憶データごと… どこにも存在していない!
の…
Just like the message from Kuri Gohan and Kamehameha.
Daru! Hacking으시로! No科学研究所だけじゃなく Victor Kondoria大学にあるデータを 全部こじ開けてくれ! サーバーから個人のPC まで全部だ!
Okidoki!
ヒアジョーさんも協力してくれ! 頼む!
But the answer was the same. Not only the Amadeus Kurisu, but the Maho as well, were nowhere to be found on the Victor Kondria servers. The twins, they're gone. There was no trace of them. Their very existence had been erased.
どこか別の場所に移されたとか?
そんなの無理だわ。 Amadeus システムに関して、そんな管理者権限を持ってるのは、レスキネン教授だけよ。
Then wouldn't it behoove one to think that it might have been him who did it?
レスキネン教授…
My mind flashed back to the message from Kuri Gohan and Kamehameha. Our Father in Heaven. Who was the Our Father in Heaven whom Clarissa had spoken of? If Amadeus considered anyone a father, it would be.
Masaka. Leskinen Kyoji ga.
Okusoku de mono o iwanai de. Sore yori mo. 教授のIDとパスがクラックされたと考える方がよっぽど現実的よ!
レスキネン教授に連絡をつける方法はあるか?
The phones weren't working, and there was no way to tell when he'd see an email or if he'd respond. Mao was thinking hard, but it didn't seem like she was having any luck. We were getting nowhere. I was concerned about Mairi, but I couldn't ignore the danger that was right in front of me.
とりあえず、ラジカンへ行ってくれ。クリスの警告通りなら… 狙われるのはあそこだ!
僕も行く!
お前とヒアジョーさんはここで情報収集だ! マユリが戻ってくるかもしれない! ただし… 何かあったらすぐに逃げろよ!
I gave my orders and ran out of the lab towards the radio building. Oh boy. Oh, we're back to Suzu! It's Suzu time! Are we gonna be able to- I still see bars on her phone, so this must be just before this. Suzuha hit the play button on her smartphone's video display. The video was heavily compressed and covered in static, but she recognized the person that appeared. It was a face she'd known her whole life, a face that had been with her both in the past and her present. The man who she still remembered holding her up in the air as a child was probably about 35 in the video.
Ya, Suzuha, genki kai? Tousan da yo. Kochira wa 2025 nen da.
2025? So it's 11 years before she came back, and 14 years before now. Next year, Okabe is supposed to quote-unquote die. We know he doesn't, at least in that one timeline.
Iroiro na koto o kimi ni takushite shimatte, hontou ni moushiwake naku omou. Kono movie mailu ga todoita toukoto wa, kimi wa, iya, kimi to Mayushi wa, Steins Gate e no michi o mata hitotsu mitsukete kureta toukoto da.
Another path?
Tsumari keikaku wa, tsugi no dankai ni ikou shita wake sa. Naze saisho kara zenbu shiji shinakatta no ka to, kimi wa okoru kamoshirenai na. Demo, shiji shinakattan ja nai da. Dekinakattan da yo. Kimi ga shippatsu shita sekaisen no boku wa, kore kara hanasu operation wo keikaku shite inakatta hazu da kara ne. Mou kizuite iru kamoshirenai ga, kimi to Mayushi no sentaku niyotte, sekaisen wa mata sukoshi hendou shita nda.
Oh!
つまり僕も君が出発した世界線とは違う別の世界線上の橋田イタルということになる。でも鈴葉、どうか勘違いしないでほしいんだ。僕はどんな世界線においても娘ラブだからね。ちなみにどうだい？比べてみて。どっちのパパの方がダンディーかな？僕は最近
筋トレを始めたんだけどさ。ふふん。誰？くだらないこと言ってないで。さっさと作戦内容を話せ。
Oh shit, he's there.
まったくだわ。まほ。 どうせまた3日坊主で終わるんだから。どうでもいい報告はしないで。録画できる時間が終わっちゃうにゅ。まあまあ。
Everybody.
そうせかすなって。ということで、 このムービーメールの本来の目的に移ろう。オペレーションアークライトの詳細を伝える。Operation
Aquila. Okay.
これは本当に一瞬のミスも許されない。ギリギリの戦いになる。心して聞くんだ。いいね。Suzuha
paused the video there. If he was telling her to pay attention, it must be important. If she was going to memorize it all, she needed to calm down. To be honest, getting a video from her dad in 2025 had made her really excited. It felt like her father was telling her that the plan she'd come up with on her own was the right one. That's why she needed to pay careful attention. Mayuri was standing by herself typing something into her phone as fast as she could. When the video had arrived, she told Mayuri that they may have to leave for the past today. There must have been some reason the video was sent today at this time. That's how it seemed to Suzuha.
?何してるの?
あ、すずさん。どう？今日出発することになりそう？作戦概要はこれから確認するつもり。そっか。あのね、もし今日出発するってなったら、マユシーは行方不明になっちゃうわけでしょ？心配かけたくないから、お父さんとお母さんと、あと、
お友達みんなにメールを書いておこうと思って。オカリンおじさんくらいには直接伝えられる時間があればいいけどね。She
would be done going over the mission and deciding on a course of action by sunset, probably.
オカリンにもメール書いたから大丈夫。メールでいいの?
Mayuri smiled and nodded. There were no more tears in her eyes, but you could still see wet lines drawn down her soft pink cheeks.
なんだか恥ずかしいから。でもね、せっかく書いたメールだけど、送れないかもしれないなーって、今ちょっと困ってたところなのです。なんで? 電波圏外になってるんだ。
Oh, it's happening.
Kengai.
Suzuha looked at the screen on Mayuri's phone. There wasn't a single bar on the antenna. Suzuha took out her own phone to double check. When she saw that Mayuri was using a different cell carrier than her, she frowned. She told Mayuri to hide behind the time machine and silently moved up against the iron door leading to the stairs. She opened it a crack, taking care not to let it creak. She looked inside the building. It was quiet as ever. There was nothing on the floor below but a room for events and some storerooms, so on weekdays like this, it was always quiet. She tilted her head sideways as she softly tried to close the door. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck! What happened? No! Every damn time! Why? At Mayuri's scream, she turned around just in time to see armed agents in camouflage jumping over the fence. One of them had grabbed Mayuri. Suzuha deeply regretted her mistake. She was well aware that someone could try to come up the walls, but the video from her dad made her so excited, she'd lowered her guard. But there were about 30 men, all carrying small assault rifles. With Mayuri as their hostage, Suzuha couldn't do anything. One of the men gave her an order in a cold voice. He pulled Mayuri close and put the gun to her head, then flipped off the safety. She had no choice but to obey. Suzuha took the gun out of her holster and put it on the ground, then took a pose where she couldn't resist. From the way they moved, she could easily tell they were veteran professionals. That meant they were certainly after the time machine, and probably well aware that only Suzuha could operate it. That, Suzuha decided, meant that they wouldn't kill her if they didn't have to. The man who had spoken to her first, who was probably the leader, knelt down next to her. She was searched, roughly, to make sure she wasn't carrying anything other than weapons. They took the other small pistol she carried for emergencies, as well as several different kinds of knives. Wait, what? Target 2 and 3? Who's target 1? The leader spoke to the group of men gathering around the time machine.
Oh.
The machine itself is target 1. Okay. Fair enough. Several of the men had gone inside the machine as well. Leaving the hatch open had been Suzuha's own mistake, but still it upset her to see them inside the machine. The leader kicked her with the heel of his boot. When she stood up, her hands were handcuffed behind her back. They prodded her from behind and moved next to the machine.
生体認証だな。そうだ。ただし、私の静脈や指紋をコピーしても無駄だ。手を切り落としたり、目玉をくり抜いたって認証には使えない。2036年のシステムはそんなにマヌケじゃない。The
men in camo seemed aware of everything she said. None of them seemed surprised or irritated.
教授はどうした?
The who? The leader asked the man who was pointing the gun at Mayuri.
現在、こちらに向かっているところです。
The professor. Oh, you've got it. Fucking Christ. This is Stratfor, isn't it? The Leskinen!
目標1は目標2とセットだ。洗脳しないと無理だと伝えろ。
Brainwashing. Great. Suzuha gritted her teeth when she heard the word brainwashing. She'd seen many of her friends in Valkyrie undergo this cruel procedure and be sent back as spies before turning into vegetables. The leader turned towards Suzuha.
洗脳の行き着く先は分かっているはずだ。教授は薬などは使わない。 直接脳をいじられることになる。そうなる前に素直に我々に協力した方が利口だと思うが。
教授か。
Where had she come from? An old doctor with that name had led a brainwashing team that had attempted to destroy Valkyrie. Suzuha had hated him more than anyone else. They hadn't used drugs either. It was safe to assume that both professors were the same person.
Wakatta.
She nodded.
You koto o kiku. Daga, kore ja muri da.
Suzuha jangled the cuffs behind her back.
手錠は外す。ただし抵抗すればそっちの女が死ぬ。
There was still a gun pointed at Mayuri's head. Even if she tried to resist, it would be impossible to save Mayuri from this many professional soldiers. When she went inside the cockpit, she used her biometrics to bypass the lock and brought up the control console. Lights came on all across the machine, and she could hear a low rumbling.
よし、降りろ。あとは我々が調査する。
あんたたちに理解できるとは思えないけどね。
As Suzuha left the cockpit, the leader turned his gaze toward a particular cluster of the men, which seemed to be engineers. That was the moment she was waiting for. Her hand had wandered below the console for just a moment when she left the cockpit. She'd hidden some knives there. Without making a sound, she threw it at the leader. The knife pierced his throat. He went down so quickly he hadn't even had time to scream.She quickly readied another knife and darted between the men in camo. Her target was the man pointing a gun at Mayuri's head. She dropped her hips low to the ground. In an instant, she moved behind him and slit his throat. Damn! Suzu! God damn it! Oh, Suzu for smash. Blood poured out onto an astonished Mayuri, but there was no time to worry about her. Yeah, there's really no time. Not now. She grabbed his rifle and fired a few shots to force them to the ground, and grabbed Mayuri's hand and ran behind the machine.The plan had gone well so far, but she had seriously underestimated how well-trained these men were. The second-in-command quickly moved to the front and worked to re-establish control. All she had was a knife and the gun she'd stolen. And she needed to protect Mayuri, a non-combatant. She was still facing more than 25 active enemies. Oh my god, there's that many? Whatever the right way to get out of this was, she couldn't find it. The time machine was still active. She couldn't escape because she couldn't leave it here. Why don't you take the machine?One of the men fired several rounds towards her, which bounced off the side of the machine. Uh-oh. Oh, no. No. And then Mayuri's head flew back as if she'd been struck. A spurt of blood came out.
Mayuri-san!
Her cute face was turning blood red. Oh my god, what? One of the rounds had grazed her after ricocheted. Okay, it was only a graze. Tis merely a flesh wound. She was clutching herself with her arms and her expression was completely blank. Her tiny body was shaking. Suzuha couldn't blame her. She fired back at the enemy, but they kept drawing closer. The time machine's maintenance hatch was right in front of her. When she saw that it was there, she visualized her last option in her mind. What? If she did that, all of her plans would be ruined. The path to Steins Gate would be forever closed. But that didn't mean she was cold-blooded enough to sacrifice Mayuri here. If the world lines were going to converge, maybe Mayuri wouldn't die here at all. But what her father had said during his video message bothered her.
もう気づいているかもしれないが、君とマユシの選択によって世界線はまた少し変動したんだ。つまり僕も君が出発した世界線とは違う別の世界線上の橋田至るということになる。
Which meant that Suzuha had no proof that Mayuri would be alive in 2036 now. Had the world line really changed?Of course, for the sake of Operation Aquila, she hoped it had. But that meant she wouldn't be able to move from this place. The worst case scenario. That would be these men taking the time machine. It could turn the world line into something even worse than the one Souza had experienced. I don't think that's an option. It might become a world line where not only Mayuri's life wasn't safe, but Daru's wasn't either. If that was going to happen, she had to make her choice fast. She kept a careful eye on the man, and as soon as she saw an opening, she opened the maintenance hatch's biometric lock. She could see part of the engine, which was still giving off a quiet rumble. She turned her gun sights on it. Fortunately, the unit that created the Kerblack hole still wasn't active. Even if she blew up the machine here, it probably wouldn't cause serious damage to the space-time continuum. As soon as she saw that, she went to pull the trigger. And Mayuri's voice stopped her. Mayuri had stopped her once before, and once again she hesitated for just another instant. On the battlefield, that instant can decide your fate. Did it, though? She took a quick look around again, and then she froze. Mixed in with the men in camo was a girl in a dark motorcycle suit and helmet. Oh, no. Was it Kagari who had leaked this place's location to them? She was well aware of Kagari's abilities after their two battles. If she wasn't completely in control of herself, she'd be killed instantly. She talked to herself. How many would she have to take with her in order to give Mayuri a chance to escape? Right now, the only thing she could afford to think about was getting Mayuri back to Rintaro Okabe. But just when she'd made her decision, she felt Kagari staring at her, or more precisely, the blood dripping down Mayuri's forehead. And just after that, oh, she's gonna go apeshit on them. Oh, she is totally gonna go apeshit on them. How dare you hurt my mother? Oh, no. Kagari did something she hadn't expected at all. Well, I mean, oh, yes. Yes, please. Please, Kagari. Take care of this for me. There was a scream. No, it was the howl of an enraged beast. And then the slaughter began. Kagari grabbed the second-in-command's head with her left hand. With her right, she steadied her rifle. After she fired, there was very little left of his head. Oh, that's hardcore! Oh my god, look at the blood on the screen now! The rest of him dropped to the ground. She slammed the piece of tattered flesh that had once been a man's head into the ground, and with no warning at all, leaped from one screaming man to another. She fired her gun into every one of them. Oh my god, this is brutal. Even when her targets were already soaked in a sea of blood, she kept firing until their limbs were blown apart into unrecognizable rags. Holy crap, she was summoned as a berserker. Oh my god. Some of them tried shooting her to protect themselves, but no matter where she was struck, Kagari didn't even flinch. Heracles, is that you? When her magazine ran dry, she drew forth long military-style cleavers. Oh my god. Holding one in each hand, she used them in her military combat training to slaughter anyone she saw. The entrails were scattered all over the twilight rooftop, covering her whole body in blood and bits of flesh. Suzuha held Mayuri's head tight to her chest. Mayuri was shaking from fear, but she did as she was told and clamped her hands down over her ears. Even so, she could probably still hear the sounds of ripping flesh and shattering bone. Even Suzuha had gone stone cold in shock. During all her time in combat, she'd never seen a one-sided slaughter like this. She'd experienced this when they fought, but Kagari seemed to feel no fear or pain. She simply focused all her energy on killing her opponent. It was often said that humans unconsciously avoided using all their muscle power to protect their own bodies, but Kagari seemed to lack that capability. Oh! Just now she stabbed a man who turned to run from her in the back and tossed his huge body to the ground with only his single arm. Then she kicked his stomach from below and ruptured his organs, killing him. Finally, after several, perhaps a dozen or more of the men had been killed, what remained of the squad started to scream orders at one another. With terrifying reflexes, she dodged between their shots and brutally murdered several more. But... at last, a hail of gunfire struck her left hand, and the knife she was holding fell to the ground. No, that wasn't it. It wasn't the knife that fell, but it was her entire left... Oh my god! The shock caused her body to stagger back. Yeah! I bet it would! I fucking hope it would! Someone screamed in a voice that lacked any of the pride and bravery a soldier is supposed to possess. Several more bullets dug into her body. Parts of the motorcycle suit ripped open and the helmet cracked. Blood that was clearly her own, not that of the men she'd killed, began to pour out. At last she fell into a pile of corpses.
Yes!
They must have thought they'd finally had her. One of the survivors pointed his gun down to finish her, and just as he was about to pull the trigger... Oh no! Her bestial roar and the man's terrified scream overlapped in a horrible cacophony. She forced herself to leap up and brought the back of the remaining cleaver down on his arm, knocking him back. An instant later, the knife slit his throat and he ended his life. The survivors began to flee in terror. Oh my god! What just... Run, Rintaro, run! But not that way, the other way! Away from the radio building! Trust me, you don't want to go there! I don't! I'm calling it here! This is the Musical Gamer signing off! I don't know what I just saw, but I don't like it! I'll see you guys in the next one! Woohoo! Fuck me!